Welcome to PC Mac. Today we are going to show you how you can reset Safari web browser on Mac OS Catalina. So let's do it. First of all, I would recommend you to please go and check whether your operating system is updated or not. How you can check is by just going on to the Apple icon from the top left corner, and then you need to click on App Store, and from here you can go ahead and check by clicking on updates that I have no updates available, and it says all your apps are up to date. So if there is any update available for your Mac operating system, you just need to update your OS to that particular update. After that, let's go further. Let's just close the App Store. Now, what we need to do is we need to click on Go, and then we need to press the Alt key, and it will bring Library here. You need to click on Library, and it will open the library in front of you, just like that. And then we need to navigate to Safari folder. We need to open it. What we are doing here, we are taking the backup of all our bookmarks, because once we reset our Safari, it will delete all the data from our operating system regarding Safari web browser. So once we open the Safari folder, you need to look for this file, that is bookmarks.plist. Either you can drag it to your screen, your desktop screen, or just copy it and then paste it on your screen like that. Or you can go ahead and paste this file to an external storage device like a flash drive. So you can see we have pasted the bookmarks.plist right here. That means we have created a copy of this file. This file contains all the bookmarks of our Safari web browser. I have documented everything in my post, so you can visit my website, that is pcmac.biz, and you will find the document over there, and I will also document the link of this post into my description. You can find the document right here, how to reset Safari browser to factory default setting on Mac Catalina. Once you open it, you will find all the details here. And you can also ask me any questions if you have facing any problem regarding resetting your Safari web browser. You can talk to me on my official Telegram chat and I will help you. Now, as we took the backup of our bookmarks, what we need to do is we need to go ahead and open Safari as we already did that. Then once we start resetting our Safari web browser, what all things we need to remove is all the installed extensions by clicking on Safari and then Preferences, and all the browsing data, cookies, saved login and passwords, and all the autofill entries will be removed once we totally reset the Safari web browser. So from here, you need to remove all the extensions that are available in this box. Just click on the extension and remove it. Then what we need to do is again click on Safari and then Clear History. By clicking on it, it will bring up this option. You just need to click here and then select All History and Clear History. Now the second step is also done. Then what we need to do is we need to move down and go to Privacy. Now we need to click on Privacy, and from here we need to click on Manage Website Data. Once we do that, it will bring some websites for you. Then you need to click on Remove All and then Remove Now. By doing this step, all these saved website data will be removed. Then you need to click on Done. This will sum up the step 3, and then in the next step what we need to do is we need to go into Advanced and then Enable Develop Menu. So let's do that as well. Go to advance and then show develop menu in the menu bar. You need to check this option and this will bring this option develop. You need to click here and then click on empty cache. Once you do that, it will remove all the cache from your Mac operating system. The cache are the information of website which we visited in past few days. Now this step is also done. Then what we need to do is we need to remove the plugins as well. How you can do that? Again, we need to navigate to the library folder by clicking here. We already in the library folder, and then we need to move down and look for the plugin folder. You need to look for this folder, Internet Plugins. Open it, and if you find any information inside this folder, then you need to just move that information, that folders or files, into your trash. By doing this fifth step, the Safari reset process is half done. Let's just close it and move here. Now what we need to do is we need to open the terminal and try to remove the remaining files from the terminal. How we can do that? Firstly, you need to click on the Apple icon and then you need to click on force quit. It will bring up the information, the list of all the applications whatsoever are running on your Mac operating system. You just need to click on the following application and then just click on force quit. You can't close the Finder, that's why it says relaunch, because we are on the Finder right now. After that, we need to remove some information through library, and let's just open the library one more time. Inside library, we need to look for cache. Right click, move to bin. It will ask for the password, so enter your password. Then the next one is cookies, that is right here. Move to bin again, and then the third folder is Safari. Move to bin. So all these folders are transferred to the bin. As you can see, the bin is full now. Now the next thing that we need to move into bin is saved application state. We need to open this folder and look for our Safari saved states. Let's just minimize this, close this option as well, and it's right here, saved application state. Once you open this folder, and the folder is right here, com.apple.safari saved state. Let's just right click and move to bin. Once all these folders successfully move to bin, then you just need to right click on the bin and empty the bin. And let's go and empty the bin. So the process is done. Now what we need to do is we need to open our terminal and copy all the below given commands. We need to copy all these given commands right here, and then we need to paste them onto our terminal, just like that. All the commands at once and hit enter. Once we do that, it will automatically clean the remaining parts of Safari, and this will fully wipe all the data of our Safari web browser and make it as on factory default settings. Now once everything is done, you can just go ahead and restart your Mac operating system, and once it's done, you can start using your Safari normally on your Mac operating system. And then you can move this folder again to the library by just going to go and then open library, open the Safari folder. It created automatically like that, and then just move the bookmark plist here again, copy it and paste it to your Safari folder. I'm using a virtual box, that's why it's lagging in some cases, so it will not be like this on your Mac operating system. Now once the bookmarks are pasted in this folder, you will get back all your stored bookmarks and favorites on your Safari again. At last, what you need to do is just click on the Apple icon and then click on shutdown. Once you click on that, you need to uncheck this option, reopen Windows when login back in, and then just click on shutdown to shut down your computer. So guys, that's it from my end. If you like my work, please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel and share this video with your family and friends. Thanks for watching. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.